Folks, it's been a wild few months for Under Armour. Shares took a tumble after a gloomy outlook was presented back in December, only to rebound again. Brian Nagel is analyst at Oppenheimer & Company. And the shares are out with their earnings this morning. Looks like an earnings per share beat, 9 cents versus the 4 cents the street had been expecting. Brian, what do you think of the numbers?
Hey, good morning. Look, I think it's mixed. I mean, like you said, Becky, there's clearly an earnings beat here. It came from gross margins and expense controls. Still some very weak spots within the revenue line, particularly North America. Now,
where in particular?
Well, North America.
So
then I don't think we got much beyond that yet at this point. But I mean, and some of that's probably self-inflicted. And this company's been in this now 2-year repositioning turnaround. They pulled back significantly on promotions. They've streamlined their operations, which is all good. So I'm sure some of that weakness here we saw in North America was, again, self-inflicted. They're positioning for better growth as we move into 2019 and beyond. But to me, that's a problem. You know, with a sector that's doing so well, we see such strong results right now out of the likes of Nike and Lululemon, that Under Armour is clearly suffering here.
The problem with Under Armour to begin with was that they were in too many outlets, too many places where they were being discounted, essentially, and they didn't differentiate between the levels of the brands. Is that?
I think that's a huge piece of it. I mean, if I step back and look at it, I think what you said was perfect. It's also a company that just grew too fast. You know, they were a high growth company. I think they wanted to remain so. So they started to push into, you know, probably some distribution partners that they should not have. Maybe they got, I know they would, you know, cringe when I say this, but I think there was some sloppiness here. They may have pushed into certain product categories that they didn't do in the best way.
But how's the cleanup going? I mean, if that's the old story of what happened, how far are they on this turnaround? And what do you think happens next? Do they get back on even footing with this and then start to pick up growth again?
That's the hope. Now, so to answer your question, how's the turnaround? They've battened down the hatches. Okay, and so I think from an internal perspective, they've done quite a good job. You know, we've seen them pull back, like I was saying a second ago, promotions and other streamlining operations. But now it's all a matter of, okay, so the business is operating better. It's in a better position. Can they drive revenue growth? Can they drive outsized revenue growth going forward? And that's the big question right now.
I had heard other analysts saying, really take a close look at the gross margins. Gross margins for the quarter were up 160 basis points to 45%. Is that a good number? Is that where they should be sitting?
That's a good number, and that's reflective of them, I think, largely pulling back on price promotions. They're probably, to a certain extent, them just getting smarter with the merchandise and the product as well. But that in and of itself is a healthy number.
What do you need to see from this company to be a believer if you're still on the fence?
Revenue growth.
What kind of revenue growth and where do they get it? You're talking North America, they've got to get those numbers back up. How do they do it if they've cut back on the number of places that they were distributing and if some of the distribution places have gone by the wayside, some of the bankruptcies that we'd seen before?
Yeah, so that's good. So look, the way they do it, this can be kind of a blasé answer, but when I think of the, you know, what's the real key test of this business, North America is still their core market. Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's important from a geographic standpoint. But then how do you do that? It's product innovation. And that's where I worry a bit. You know, that because you see, again, I've watched Nike and Lululemon among others. There's just some incredible innovation that's come out of those companies. So when I think about Under Armour, and here's Under Armour turning its business around, getting back on its footing, it's not doing that in a vacuum. You know, it's doing that against the likes of some very strong companies that are, you know, that are innovating in their own right.